For the latest film interviews, reviews and everything making news in pop culture, subscribe to Film Companion now. Malayalam cinema is flourishing. Hindi cinema is languishing. A mid-year unscientific survey of the Indian film industry throws up that conclusion. In year two of the pandemic, which is in some ways harder than year one because we imagined that we would be out of the woods by now, films from Kerala have sustained and nourished us. These stories of human frailty, hubris, family, relationships, good and evil, crime and punishment have startled us with their originality and craft. Meanwhile, Bollywood seems to have lost its moorings, epitomized by the bloated mess that was Radhe. Thanks to streaming platforms, audiences have access to the best from across the country. I hope that raises our standards and makes us demand more. Here are my favorites from the first half of 2021. Special mentions, Sanu John Varghese's Arkaryam, Dibakar Banerjee's Sandeep or Pinky Farrar, and Ivan Iyer's Meel Pathar. At number 10, Mandela. Mandela could be a spin-off from the Munna Bhai universe. The title character, played by a terrific Yogi Babu, seems like Munna's Tamilian brother. A good-hearted, naive game-changer who throws into the spotlight the greed and corruption of those around him. Mandela even has a circuit-like sidekick. Writer-director Madone Ashwin tells a timely story about caste, democracy and marginalization with humor and compassion. The satire bites, but it never becomes vicious. At number 9, Nayata. Nayata means the hunt. In Martin Prockett's disturbing police procedural, the hunters are cops, but the hunted are also cops. After a road accident, three police officers get embroiled in a cauldron of caste politics and violence and are forced to flee. What's fascinating is how Martin and writer Shahi Kabir, a police officer himself, consistently humanize the characters. So even during the tense pursuit, the narrative finds room for moments of silence, introspection, and ordinary decency. In one of my favorite scenes, a man wordlessly buys sanitary napkins for a woman. In how many films have you seen that happen? At number 8, Gilipuchi. Bharti Mandal is female, Dalit, and gay. That intricate intersectionality is perhaps a first for Hindi cinema. Except this isn't a feature. In a 43-minute short film, director and writer Neeraj Khewan tells a searing story of the hesitant intimacy that develops between two women from opposite sides of the class and caste divide. Konkona Sen Sharma as Bharti combines external toughness with vulnerability and a rage that flashes in her eyes as she understands that it is impossible to navigate the chasm between them. And Aditi Rao Hedri is the perfect foil as Priya, naive, fragile and trapped in upper caste patriarchy. Gilipuchi is a masterclass in saying more with less. At number 7, Jati Ratnalu. I'm also a responsible citizen Kane of this country. How can you resist a film that features that dialogue? Jati Ratnalu, about three small town boys who come to the big city, Hyderabad, looking for jobs, money and the good life, is a sparkling concoction of humor, social commentary and terrific chemistry between the leads. Naveen Polishetty as Srikant, Rahul Ramakrishna as Ravi and Priyadarshi as Sekhar. Director and writer Anudeep K.V. also peppers the film with hat tips to all the films he's loved. This is a film I wish I'd seen in a theatre. It would have been magical to sit with strangers and laugh. At number 6, Karnan. Karnan is a powerful call to arms. Director Mari Salvaraj reimagines the Mahabharata so that the demigod Karna is no longer a good man on the wrong side. Instead, he is the savior of his people and his village, Podiyankulam. Unlike his first film, Pariyam Perumal, which portrays a determined but peaceful rebellion against the caste system, Karnan tells us that sometimes violence is the answer. The film features striking visual imagery, the terrific song Kandavara Solunga by Santosh Narayanan, and a blazing performance by Dhanush as Karnan. He's both myth and everyman, and that is an unbeatable combination. At number 5, Drishyam The Resumption. Honestly, I didn't think writer-director Jeetu Joseph could pull off a sequel to his superbly scripted Drishyam, in which we're rooting for George Kuti and his family to get away with murder. The second film isn't as seamlessly constructed as the first. The first act is plodding. But once the plot kicks in, Joseph takes us on a gripping saga of crime and punishment. George Kuti's deceptions are so elaborate that they will take your breath away. And superstar Mohanlal plays the character superbly with just the right inflection of sorrow and scarring. At number 4, Kala. A fractured father-son relationship, a home invasion horror story, the casual callousness of the privileged and the rage of the underprivileged. Kala packs in a lot. Director Rohit V.S., DOP Akhil George, Don Vincent, the director of music and sound design, and editor Chaman Chako construct a beautifully crafted immersive experience of one man's hell. Lead and co-producer Tovino Thomas delivers a brilliant performance as an entitled man who is fighting his own frustration and failure, but who is also taught a brutal lesson. The teacher, a laborer played by Sumesh Moore, is terrifying and terrific. The mayhem and brutality in Kala is relentless, but Rohit doesn't allow us to look away either from the consequences of violence or the consequences of our actions. At number 3, Joji. In the hands of Malayalam cinema's dream team, director Dilish Pothan, writer Shyam Pushkaran and actor Fahad Fasil, Macbeth becomes a riveting drama about a deeply dysfunctional family. A formidable patriarch controls his 3 sons and his vast estate with an iron fist until a stroke confines him. Now the family members must negotiate between their true feelings for this despotic figure and the mournful facade that society requires. Joji, played by a terrifically unnerving Fahad Fasil, puts into motion a chain of events that lead to murder. As Joji plots, he discovers his own capacity for cruelty and his utter lack of morals. But Pothan layers this disturbing story with touches of humor and whimsy. It is a thing of beauty. At number 2, The Disciple. The Disciple is a meditative character study that draws you deep into its mysterious spell. Using stillness, long takes and wide shots, director Chaitanya Tamhane tells the haunting, melancholic story of a Hindustani classical vocalist, Sharad Nerulkar, who gives his life in the pursuit of his art. But Sharad slowly discovers the dichotomy between the purity he seeks and the reality of the marketplace and the reality of his own talent. Singer and debutante actor Aditya Modak transforms externally and internally as we watch. And as that happens, Chaitanya asks us to consider the cost of Sharad's devotion. Like Sharad, we ask, was it worth it? And at number 1, The Great Indian Kitchen. The Great Indian Kitchen is a gutting portrait of domestic slavery, of the lives that millions of women in this country lead, toiling away unpaid and unsung. Nimisha Sajayan plays a housewife, unnamed because director Jio Baby wants us to understand that she is every woman. Her first flush of excitement when she has an arranged marriage slowly gives way to seething anger. The film is brilliant because Jio doesn't create high drama or outsized villains. Instead, he showcases the horror of the ordinary. The pile of unwashed utensils, the disgusting kitchen waste, the half-chewed bones and spilled curry that men leave on the dining table for women to clean. The women are second-class citizens, only there to serve. The rage of the housewife becomes your rage. This film should be required viewing in educational institutions. What did you think of my list of the top films of the first half of 2021? Does it match yours? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below.